Why EA Sports and Codemasters stopped developing cricket games? This question lies within the minds of almost each and every cricket gamer. That's why they took the call to stop creating cricket games. Right from the start, none of the EA's cricket series game added value or say gained global attention as cricket was not EA's priority. All expectations and rumors regarding EA Sports planning to resurrect the cricket series were put to rest when their vice president categorically mentioned that cricket was no longer their focus. There are, however, five another cricket games by Bigand Studios with updated graphics and gameplay mechanics which even follow the latest rules of cricket. Unlike all previous cricket games published by EA and Codemasters. But unfortunately, that game series is going fast downhill with funny physics, bugs, and due to the complexity of the game. Bigand Studios' first two cricket games, Don Bradman Cricket 14 and Don Bradman Cricket 17, had a lot of potential. But when they first released those games, they had a lot of problems. With the time period, Bigand Studio released many patches for Don Bradman cricket games, and those issues were fixed. But by then, it was too late, and those games became outdated, as there were some new releases of cricket games from Bigand Studios, like Ashes Cricket 17, Cricket 19, and Cricket 22. Their latest game is Cricket 22. And believe me, that game is a disaster, and it feels so arcadish. So diehard fans of cricket no longer have faith in Bigand Studios. Only if they had continued with Don Bradman cricket series and not make games meant to be played by real cricket mobile gaming fans. Initially, EA Sports cricket series was widespread and popular solely in three cricket playing nations, England, Australia, and New Zealand. However, its main market was clearly in Asian countries, and that too in South Asia. Cricket 96 was the first game in the series, having been developed by Melbourne House and published by the EA Sports. The version was, however, merely an update on the game Super International Cricket, released by Super Nintendo in 1994. Cricket 96 was released as Ian Botham's International Cricket 96 in Europe. Cricket 97 was a marked improvement with better graphics, three-dimensional stadiums, and commentary by Richie Bernard and Ian Botham. But there was no great change in the representation of the players, and like in the previous versions, the two-dimensional sprites continued to be used. Cricket Ashes Tour 97 released with the updated statistics and players just after the 1998-99 Ashes Tour, and it was by then one of the most realistic cricket games on the market. By 2004, the EA Sports cricket series had been hugely worked upon to improve the gameplay and the graphics. Designed by HB Studios and published by EA Sports, Cricket 2002 and EA Sports Cricket 2004 included all the international teams and the domestic teams from Australia and England. The game was released simultaneously for Windows and PlayStation 2. However, IGN adjudged that the game had the worst PlayStation 2 graphics. Notwithstanding the debate over the quality of the graphics, Cricket 2004 proved to be popular, inspiring EA Sports to come out with an improved version. the very next year. Cricket 2005 had three different region-based covers and was released for the Windows, PlayStation 2, and Xbox platforms. Cricket 2007, which is loved by millions of gamers, especially Indians, was the last game released in the EA Sports Cricket series. Though some notable additions like new venues, weather conditions, and 5-day test matches were introduced, the improvement in the gameplay and the graphics was far from satisfactory. EA Sports also lost the licensing rights for quite a few teams and went with the generic player names. Rampant piracy from these regions, however, seriously marred their profit margins, and the series never produced the estimated revenues. As EA Sports ran into a legal deadlock with the BCCI and lost the licensing rights to the Indian players, their problems only got compounded. With a shrinking market and very few people interested in the sport, the cricket series was condemned to die out soon. It eventually began to cut the interest and revenues of EA Sports. Gamers were no longer interested in a game with poor gameplay, unimpressive graphics, and silly generic names for the players. EA Sports eventually did not feel it was necessary to develop a series that was already running at a loss. Also, they had so many issues related to licensing and really struggled to gain revenue from the previously released cricket games. The sole reason behind the end of the cricket series was the lack of worldwide demand for cricket games. Not only the EA company, but another cricket game, Brian Lara Cricket Series by Codemasters, also suffered the same fate, and eventually decided the same. After a long suffering, they shifted their focus to provide demanding games around the globe, which is football. Due to this, eventually, FIFA games took place of cricket games. In the market, as there are only 10 to 12 major playing nations to play cricket, and in these majority of them are Asian gamers. By the end of 2007, the cricket games started getting faded away in terms of popularity, as the game is not up to the demand of Asian gamers. Thanks to Planet Cricket, who took over the charge, many players collaborated and start developing mods and patches for Cricket 2007. This entirely changed the whole perspective of the game. The patches started getting developed at a large scale. Many modding studios started developing Cricket 2007 patches. From 2008 to until now in 2023, the patches are still being developed for every series tournaments. This shows the true nature of the game, as it is still loved by millions of gamers. And with no immediate probability of such a global expansion, cricket-based electronic video games do not seem to have much of a future as of now. Being an ardent EA Sports cricket follower, I regret to say that in the near future, they have no plans to invest in development of new version of cricket game. Speaking 4 years back in an interview, Mr. Andrew Wilson, who is the CEO of Electronic Arts, put forward the following reasons for discontinuing the EA Sports cricket series. Post-2007. The company has always faced piracy problems in the Indian market, and also few years ago, they found themselves in a legal deadlock with BCCI, and they also lost licensing rights to Indian players. This led to the death of the game in the Indian market. Considering the population of England and Australia, it's hard for the company to expect any profit from those countries. Besides, the other games like FIFA being popular in way more number of nations, approximately 209, and investing in them would obviously result in much better revenues. But on brighter side, Mr. Wilson said in that interview, company will surely again think upon developing cricket series. We just have to wait and follow other fantastic cricket games that are available. Hope that makes you happy. EA is a profit-based corporation that builds games. No software company would ever venture into a field where its copyrights are themselves in jeopardy. Exception is in the case of Microsoft Windows, which is again only due to a subtle reason. That's the case with EA's cricket series. The last cricket game from EA was Cricket 07. It was extensively pirated in India and Pakistan, thanks to poor enforcement of anti-piracy laws. Same is not the case in Europe and the US. Every household with a kid and a computer in India essentially have EA Cricket 07, FIFA, Counter-Strike, Grand Theft Auto, and yes, all of them are pirated. But nowhere in the US and Europe is cricket the most popular sport. Football, basketball, baseball have the upper hands there, even in England. Cricket doesn't dominate soccer in popularity. Hence, EA effectively has no profitable customers to sell cricket games. You may still argue that new FIFAs are being developed, but EA FIFA has worldwide players, unlike EA Cricket. Being an inquisitive teen, I have failed miserably many times trying to find out an authentic torrent to download the latest version of EA Sports Cricket. And each of these times, I ended up downloading a patch to the original Cricket 07, with some tweaked rosters and player outlooks, and sometimes new leaks. The only problem was, I had no idea how to install these patches. Personally, I dislike this game, because there is very little for the user to control in the game. Though, the bowling makes some sense. In batting, a little timing and a suitable combination of arrows and keys, such as SDA, produces a six of each ball. So, folks, stop searching for an authentic version of the latest EA Cricket game, as they don't exist and they won't be developed in future, unless anti-piracy is enforced in India appreciably. It's highly unlikely to expect another cricket game from EA, as the Cricket 2007 version failed to achieve its market targets. The main reason being most nations playing cricket are developing nations, Asian countries, the Caribbean, a few African countries, where piracy is prevalent, and hardly anyone buys an original DVD of the game. So why would EA invest in such a market where it won't get any profits? At the end of the day, Electronic Arts is a private company and will not launch a product whose productive market will be limited only to scarcely populated countries such as England, New Zealand, Australia, and South Africa. If proper and effective anti-piracy laws are set up in these nations, then we can expect EA to start thinking about developing a new cricket game altogether. So that was it about today's video. I hope you liked today's video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to Irrational Gamer. Goodbye.